Hello guys. In this video, we will be looking at the answer for four things. Number 1, who are the two people to have controlled time in human history? Spoiler, the two people to have controlled time are Julius Caesar and Pope Gregory. They are called time controllers. But why? Let's see in the video. Second, on the night of September 2, 1752, all people in Europe and both South and North America had gone to sleep, and when they woke up, the date was September 14, 1752. We will see how three entire continents time travel 12 days into the future. Third, why will the form of calendar we use today be thrown away in the year 4000? Yes. It is going to happen. There will be a shift to a new form of calendar in the year 4000. But why? Let's see the answer for that too in this video. Finally, we will also see why April 1st is celebrated as Fool's Day every year. Okay. Cool. Let's start the video. But before that, we have to understand what a year is. 1 year is the time taken by Earth to complete one full round or revolution around the Sun. This year was used to see the distance between the Sun and the Earth and basically to differentiate seasons. Today, 1 year is 365.25 days. This was first measured by Aryabhatta, an Indian scientist, around 1,500 years ago, precisely to 10 digits. But we are not going to see about India. We are gonna see about the Romans and Greeks. They had actually miscalculated the duration of 1 year to be 364 days. And they devised a calendar in that manner, with 13 months each having 28 days. No confusion, like we have 30 days and some months today, 31 in few, suddenly 28 days in February, etc. It was simple. 13 months, each having 28 days. 13 times 28 equals 364. This calendar was followed in Rome for a long time till an emperor named Julius Caesar came to power. Caesar noticed that one of their harvest festival did not fall on a particular date every year. The date was getting delayed every year. 1 year, the festival fell during spring, and the following year it fell during winter. There was utter confusion. He understood that there was some miscalculation about the duration of 1 year. So he formed a group of great scientists to verify the exact duration of 1 year so that the festivals could fall on the same date each year and there would no confusion based on seasons. The scientists too found the blunder in their system of calendars and said Caesar that he was right, because the duration of 1 year was not 364, but 365 days and 6 hours. So Caesar had devised a new form of calendar that we use today and gave rules that January would have 31 days, February would have 28, and so on for 12 months. The feature of this calendar was a day that was added to February every 4 years, or the leap day. But the first day of this calendar, which he named Julian calendar, was April 1st, and the last day was March 31st. All these happened 50 to 60 years before the birth of Jesus Christ. Then years passed swiftly and the new form of religion named Christianity had spread and reached most parts of the world. The church became the most influential place, and the Pope, who was the head of Catholics, became the most influential person. There was one Pope in around 500 CE named Pope Gregory, who noticed that the festival of Easter, which had been falling during spring season initially, had been delaying every year. So, like Caesar, Gregory too formed a group to find the duration of 1 year exactly. And he found that the duration of the year was not 365 days and 6 hours as suggested by Caesar, but it was 365 days, 5 hours and 49 minutes. Caesar's calendar actually added an additional 11 minutes to each year. This 11-minute difference had played tantrums on the seasons and the months they fell on. So, Pope Gregory himself made a calendar which he called Gregorian calendar by reducing 11 minutes from the Julian calendar. This Gregorian calendar is the calendar that we are using today, and it starts with January 1st and ends on December 31st. That time, there was no internet, so Gregory had to send messengers and horses, and they had to take this news of the new calendar to the common people. But not all people accepted it. Only Catholic Christians had accepted it because they had respect for the Pope, but there is another section of Christians called Protestants who refuse to go by the Pope's words. So, few use the Julian calendar while few use the Gregorian calendar. This led to serious differences. Like if you ask what is the date to two people, one would answer April 1st and the other would answer January 1st. Still, many members refused to follow the Gregorian calendar. Even if the rulers of major empires like French, Dutch, Spanish, etc. agreed to use Gregorian calendar as they were Catholics and dared not to disobey the Pope. So, they implemented a law stating that people who still celebrate April 1st as New Year would be addressed as fools, which was a highly offensive word then, just to force the subjects to agree to the Gregorian calendar. This was how April 1st came to be celebrated as Fool's Day. Finally, in September 1752, after lots of disputes, people around Europe, North and South America where Christianity was prevalent had decided to adopt the Gregorian calendar. So, the new calendar was adopted, and this 11-minute difference every year had gradually added up to around 11 days. So, these 11 days were skipped in the whole calendar of September 1752. This is why those who went to sleep on the 2nd of September 1752 had woken up on the 14th of September 1752. This day was the global switch from Julian to Gregorian calendar, and that was the beginning of the era of the calendar we use today. Now, scientists say that there is the same problem prevailing in the Gregorian calendar too, with a minor shift in time. So, the Gregorian calendar will be disposed and a new calendar would be accepted in the year 4000. No one watching this video would be alive in the year 4000. I don't even know if the Earth would exist or not. But if it does, the people living in the year 4000 would have a different calendar from what we are using today.